Okay, good day. So for this video, we'll be discussing Module 10 of Engineering Physics, which is the topic heat transfer. So when you talk about heat transfer, this basically means that there is movement of heat or thermal energy. And there usually, this transfer now would happen from a warmer object to a cooler object. Okay, so it's always from warm to cold. So it's never cool to warm. Okay, so with this, heat transfer now would be defined using the concept of heat denoted or symbolized by Q, small letter Q. So for heat, this is now a form of energy that is transferred from one object to another due to a difference in your temperature. And this difference of temperature, as we have defined in heat transfer, is from a higher temperature to a lower temperature. Okay? So this heat now would be measured in calories or in joules. Okay? So for temperatures that we use for heat in our computations, this would now be defined using Celsius, your Fahrenheit, or your Kelvin. So what are the factors that would affect our heat transfer or your energy transfer? So this would now include our mass or the mass of the objects that will experience the energy or heat transfer, the specific heat of that object, and the temperature. So with that, we could now determine the equation for heat, which is Q, which is now given by the equation MC delta T. Okay? So this will be our main equation for almost all of the problems that we'll be discussing in heat transfer. So in heat transfer, there are different processes wherein we transfer heat from one object to another. And these processes are what we call your heat process. So there are three processes that is used to transfer heat. And the first one is what we call conduction. Conduction now is simply the thermal energy transfer between neighboring molecules due to a temperature gradient. Okay? So the temperature gradient now would simply be the rate of change of temperature with respect to the distance. So basically, for the conduction, this is the transfer of energy from particle to particle will occur when there is collision or direct interaction between particles. Okay, so ibig sabihin, for conduction, there should be a physical contact between the two. Okay, so examples of your conduction would include touching a rod in direct contact with flame. Okay, so another one would be when you touch your caldero with your bare hands. So napapasok kayo. So the change now in or the transfer now from kaya nyo naramdaman, kaya kayo napaso, but nyo naramdaman yung init is because of conduction. Because you directly touch the caldero. So that heat from the caldero was transferred to your hands, which is of lower temperature. Okay? So another example would be an ice melting on your hand. So the transfer there is because the ice is directly on the hand. Okay? So the transfer now would happen from the heat of the hand going to the ice. That's why the ice is melting. Okay? So under conduction, we have different objects now that we would be characterized as either an insulator or a conductor. Okay? So what are the difference between insulators and conductors? When we talk about insulators, these are now objects or materials that does not transfer heat very well. So, hindi kaya ng heat na dumaan or mag-transfer ng heat doon. Hindi kaya ng object na mag-absorb o kaya magpa-transfer, magpadaan ng heat doon sa material. Kaya nga tayo gumagamit ng insulator sa mga bahay natin, sa mga bubong ninyo, para hindi mag-transfer yung heat from the sun through the roof. So, that's one explanation or application of your insulators. Okay? While for conductors, this would now be materials that are used or are very good at transferring heat. Okay? So, For this, insulators, now examples would be your air, wood, and wool. Diba? So, pag malamig, mas gumagamit tayo ng wool jackets. Kasi, mas mahirap mag-transfer yung heat. Hindi na, mas nakukulong yung heat sa katawan natin pag malamig yung panahon. Pag wool ang gamit nyong jacket. So, that's an insulator. Okay? And then, an example for conductors would include your silver, copper, your fiberglass, your tiles, your steel. Kaya yung mga stainless steel ninyo, pag hinawakan ninyo, madaling mag-transfer yung init. Yung mga paglutuan ninyo. So, yung mga stainless steel, yung mga teflon pans ninyo, those are conductors because they transfer heat very well para maluto yung mga naluluto ninyong pagkain. So, yun lang naman yung pwede nyong gamitin to identify insulators and conductors. So, insulators, they do not transfer heat that well. So, pag mag-iisip kayo, insulator, jacket, wool jackets. Conductors, ito yung mga paglutuan para madaling ma-distribute yung heat. Okay? So, let's move. So, okay. Still under conduction. So, for conduction, the heat transfer now can be computed as K times A delta T times T divided by time. So, what are these variables? So, basically, your Q is the heat conducted or the heat transferred, which is measured in calories or joules. We have your K, which is a constant. That is now your coefficient of thermal conductivity with units calories per second centimeter degree Celsius or joules per second meter degree Celsius. Okay? And then we have your A, or the area, which is either in centimeter squared or meter squared. And we have your delta T, which is the change in temperature. So again, pag heat transfer, it is from hot to cold. So, yung change of temperature natin, usually final minus initial, di ba? Pero dito, sa conduction or sa heat transfer, it will always be hot minus cold. That's your change in temperature. Okay. So, next, we have your time, T, which is in seconds. And we have your D, which is the thickness of the object transferring the heat, which is in meters or centimeters. So, the next process under heat transfer is what we call your convection. So, when we see convection, this would be the heat transfer by motion of volume of hot fluid from one place to other. So, basically, convection is the transfer by the motion. So, from cool or from hot to cool and then cool to hot. Okay? So, the transfer now is by the actual movement of your heated material itself. So, isipin ninyo yung mga convection stove ninyo. So, sa convection stove, yung heat transfer niya is not necessarily by direct contact, but it is by the movement of the molecules that would heated molecules or of the material that is being heated. Okay? So, there are two types of convection. We have your forced convection and your natural convection. So, what's the difference between the two? When we say forced convection, the heated substance now is forced to move by a fan or a pump. So, the word force. So, pinipilit natin na mag-move yung heated substance ninyo. While for natural convection, it is now a convection or a transfer wherein the change in density takes place when your fluid is heated. So, when we talk about fluids, again, this is either air or liquid. Okay? So, example of forced convection is the heat transfer of a stove. So, a convection stove would have a fan or a pump that would force the heat in your coils to move so that it will be able to heat up your calderos or your kawales. Okay? And then, for natural convection, an example of this will be your water vapor that would fog the glass inside your bathroom because of the hot temperature of water. So, how does it happen? So, because of the hot temperature of your water, may water vapor. So, yung movement, ano yung nagmo-move doon? Yung water vapor ninyo. Okay? So, there is convection. So, under convection, we could also solve our heat transferred or heat convected through the equation Q is equal to HA delta T times the time. So, Q here, again, is measured in calories or joules, which is your heat conducted or heat transferred. H will be your heat transfer coefficient, measured in watts per meter squared Kelvin. Your A is your area. Delta T will be your temperature difference between the surface and bulk of the fluid away from the surface. And T will be the time in seconds. Okay? So, for your H values or your heat transfer coefficients, so there are different values for atmospheric pressure depending on the orientations of your materials. So, the first one is when the horizontal plate with air passing through the top surface. So, ibig sabihin, yan, you have here a plate, this is your plate. So, the hot air now, or the hot fluid, would be passing through this portion, so the top surface, okay? So, if that's the case, then your H now will be computed as 2.49 times the change in the temperature raised to 1/4. Okay? Another scenario for your H values is when the horizontal plate now, you have a horizontal plane, but the air now or the fluid will be passing at the bottom surface. So, this is your plate. Yung ating hot air will be passing at the bottom. So, it's moving here, this bottom side. So, for your H, that will now be equivalent to 1.31 times the change in temperature raised to 1/4. Okay? Another one is when we have a vertical plate. So, yung plate niya naman is this one. So, it's either moving at this side, the hot air or your fluid is passing on one side or on the other side. So, if that's the case, if you have a vertical plate, your H value now will be computed as 1.77 times 10 or times the change in temperature raised to 1/4. And lastly, if we have a horizontal plate or vertical plate with a diameter D. So, ibig sabihin, for this one now, so you have a circular plate already. Okay. So, if that's the case, so yung kanina, 1, 2, 3 are flat plates. Dito, circular plates. So, it's either horizontally oriented or vertically oriented. Then, the H now will be equivalent to 4.19 times the change in temperature all over D. The quantity raised to 1/4. Okay? So, that's for your convection. So, the example or the last process for thermal transfer is our radiation. So, when we talk about radiation, it would now take place or the heat transfer would take place by means of your electromagnetic waves. So, if you would remember our discussion of electromagnetic waves, it means there are no medium required in order to transfer your energies. Okay? So, meaning it's in air or in vacuum. So, radiation now is wherein the electromagnetic waves would be transferring or transmitting the energy from a source to an absorber. So, example of this is the sun and us. So, the sun transmits its solar or its heat energy through the air, through space, and then through the Earth's atmosphere, and it is absorbed by the people, by the objects on Earth. Okay? So, other examples, the transmission of electromagnetic waves through your microwave oven. So what happens inside your microwave ovens is that it heats the food inside the microwave through electromagnetic waves. Okay? So there is no motion of the particle. There's no touching, no physical contact. So it's simply a transmission through waves. Other example of radiation would be the light emitted by your incandescent lamps. Okay? So, just a review. For conduction, that is transfer. So, review natin. Okay? So, for conduction, it is a transfer through touching or contact. And then we have for convection, this is transfer by the movement of the heated object or of the heated particle. And for radiation, this is transfer through electromagnetic waves. Okay? So there are also instances. So this is another example. So we have emission of gamma rays by your nucleus. So for radiation, we could compute for the heat transferred by the equation sigma times tau times A times T raised to 4 times T, wherein, again, Q is your calories or joules, which is the heat transferred or radiated. Sigma will be your Stefan-Boltzmann constant, which is measured in watts per meter squared, k raised to 4. And the constant value now is 5.67 times 10 raised to negative 8. Okay? And then we have your tau, which is your transmissivity. And the area is equal to meter squared. And T is your surface temperature, and this now is measured in kelvins, and T is your time in seconds. Okay, so for this equation, there is another way to write this. So we also have your epsilon, or no, that's not epsilon, so we have sigma times epsilon times your A times T raised to 4 raised to T. So, instead of the transmissivity, minsan meron tayong tinatawag na epsilon, which is your emissivity. Okay? So, when we say transmissivity, yun yung measure nung kakayahan niya para mag-transmit ng radiation. Emissivity will be yung parang ability niya to absorb the radiation. Okay? So, that's for radiation. So, to understand heat processes further, let's have some examples with figures to identify or differentiate the different heat processes. So, the for conduction, again, it is by touching. So, we have here your rod touching the flame directly. So, there is heat transfer from the candle, from the fire, to the rod. Okay? And then, pag nainitan na ng sobra yung rod ninyo, there is also now conduction between the heated rod and your hands. Okay? Another example of conduction is when you are touching your pots. Okay? Your cooking pots. So, there's contact. So, that's conduction. Next, we have your convection. So, an example will be the movement of the hot air inside the balloon. So, that's convection. So, the movement, the moving particles, hot particles, is the air molecules. Next, we have your heat process when boiling water. So, paano ba nahi-heat yung ating tubig sa pots ninyo. So, conduction from the fire to the pot. And then, yung convection, nangyayari siya doon sa loob ng pot ninyo. So, umiinit ngayon yung nandito sa lower portion. And then, the water molecules on the bottom part will now start moving circularly to transfer its heat in the upper portion, which is colder. So, yung colder water molecules natin, natutulak siya pababa. So, pag natulak siya pababa, maiinitan siya. Okay? So, habang nagtatagal yung movement na to, painit ng painit yung tubig ninyo. Kasi nawawala yung cold water molecules. Okay? And lastly, we have your radiation. So, radiation will be from the fire. The heat of the fire will be moving through space. So, there's no medium. Hindi mo kailangan ng kahit na ano para ma-experience or ma-transfer nung fire yung heat sa kamay mo. Another is yung sinabi ko kanina, the heat of the sun that is moving through space and is absorbed by the earth. Okay? So, there are also instances wherein the heat processes will be happening all at once. So, example of that is inside a room. So, there is now convection. So, your cold air now will pass through. So, there's movement. Okay, convection, cold air and hot air. There's radiation if you have fireplace inside your room. Conduction, yung init ng ating fire is transferred through its touch or its physical contact with the floor. Another example of this is yung sa ating cooking pot. So, yung sabi ko kanina. So, pag nakadikit ngayon yung apoy doon sa ating pot, conduction yun. Pero kunwari, meron tayong mga pinagpapatungan, so hindi sila nagdidikit, then yung transfer is through radiation. Okay, so pag may space sa pagitan nila, it is a radiation. Pag nagkadikit sila, it's conduction. And then the movement of the hot molecules inside the water is through convection. And then there's water vapor. So from here, yung water vapor natin na mainit, umaangat. Kaya pag nilagay mo din yung kamay mo doon, napapasok ka. Because there is the movement of hot air molecules. And then you have your conduction. So pag still din ito. So, if this is a conductor, may initan din yung maghahawak sa handle. Okay? So, that's it for heat transfer. So, let's solve now. So, okay, to understand heat transfer, let's solve some example problems. So, for number one, determine the rate of heat transfer by conduction per unit area by means of conduction for a furnace wall made of fire clay. The furnace wall is 15 centimeters thick. Thermal conductivity of the furnace is given at 0.3 watt per meter Kelvin. And the furnace operating temperature is 650 degrees Celsius, which is the same as the furnace wall temperature. And the temperature of the outer wall of the furnace is at 150 degrees Celsius. So, for this, we're given now our hotter temperature, T1, is 650, lower temperature is 150 degrees. So, D is 15 centimeters, or that's 0.15 meters. We're given the K value, which is 0.3 watts per meter Kelvin. So, for our solution for conductivity, Q now, or the heat transfer by conduction, is equal to K times delta A, or K times A times delta T times T divided by the thickness. So, for this, we are required for the heat transfer. So, we're required the heat transfer per unit area. Okay? So, in this manner, for the equation, I'll remove A in the equation. So, with that, I'll have our equation as the heat per unit area is equal to A K times delta T times T. So take note, for our K, it is in kelvins. So therefore, our temperature must be converted to kelvins also. Okay? So this should also be in kelvins. So if we're going to substitute, that will now be 0.3 times 650 minus 150. Okay? So bakit hindi ko na siya i-convert sa... Ba't di ko kinonvert ito sa Kelvin? Kahit na dapat naka-Kelvin. Kasi, pag kinumpute ko yan, so pag kinonvert ko, 650 plus 273. So, 650 plus 273, that is equal to 923. So, 150 plus 273 is 423, which is equal now to, pag pinag ko, kinuha ko yung difference, 923 minus 423 is 500. So, 650 minus 500 is also 500. Okay? So, kaya hindi siya na-convert. Pero, supposedly, dapat i-convert natin. Though, hindi na siya kinonvert since the 273 conversion will be deducted also from both, or will cancel out from both temperatures. Okay, so with that, we'll get now a value of Q per A is equal to 1000 watts per unit area. Okay, so basically itong answer natin also, since wala namang time na sinasabi or duration ng pagkakadikit nila, we could also say that this is per unit seconds also. Okay? Though we use only 1 second so that we could cancel out our answers or your units. Okay? Let's move to the next problem. Okay? So, we have example number 2. So, determine the overall heat transfer by conduction occurring across a furnace wall made of fire clay and having a thickness of 0.3 meters. The wall is insulated from outside, and the thermal activity values for the wall and the insulation materials are 0.1 and 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin respectively. The furnace operates at 650 degrees Celsius, and the average ambient temperature outside the furnace wall is 30 degrees. And the allowable temperature on the outer side of the insulation is 80 degrees Celsius. So if the air side heat transfer coefficient is 0.4 watts per meter squared Kelvin, calculate now the minimum insulation of thickness required. So how are we going to solve this? So let's draw a diagram to help us with our analysis. So this one is our furnace wall, and this one is our insulation wall. Okay, so to solve now for the minimum thickness of the insulation wall, then we have to consider that the heat conducted between the materials would be equal. Okay, so dapat, bakit siya equal? Kasi dapat kung ano yung na-produce ni furnace as much as possible is kayang i-absorb nung insulation natin. At yung kakayahan ng insulation wall to absorb the heat of the furnace would also be dependent on the thickness of the insulation. So, kung masyadong manipis ito, then, ibig sabihin, may matatransfer na heat dito sa side ng insulation na to. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, makakatakas yung init ng furnace sa insulation. So, dapat meron tayong minimum thickness para hindi makawala yung heat ng furnace ninyo. So, yun yung gusto kong kaya natin sinasabing equal dapat yung ibibigay ni furnace sa i-absorb ni insulation. So, with that, we could write now that Q wall is equal to
the insulation or the heat absorbed by the insulation. So for this, we'll now be using our equation for conduction, which is equal to K times A times the change in your temperature times the time divided by the thickness. So for our wall, okay, we're given its K value, where we have the area. So yung area nila in contact will be the same, so we could cancel this out, okay? So delta T will be the temperature experienced by the furnace. So it is from 650 moving to the temperature na katabi niya nung insulation. Okay? So the temperature outside the furnace wall, so dito ang 650 degrees, sa kabilang side niya is 30 degrees. Okay? So, yan yan. So, that's for our delta T. So, malamang every time naman siyang magkadikit, so we could also neglect this one, or we could simply say this is 1 second. Okay? So, the thickness is given at 0.3. So, we could write now for Q wall, that is 0.01 times your area times 650 minus 30 times the time divided by 0.3. Okay? For the insulation, we're given the K value. Its change in the temperature now will be from the outside, which is 80 degrees. So, papunta doon. So, that will be 80 minus 30. So, times time times the area divided by the thickness. Okay? So, we have 0.1. So, area ng contact nila is the same. So, it cancels out. Dahil magkadikit sila, so yung time na magkasama sila would also be the same. So, T also cancels out. Okay? So, no need for those. So, ang only unknown is the insulation. Okay? So, again, for delta T, it is always hot minus cold. So, with that, we only have one unknown. So, we could compute now for our insulation thickness. Then, from here, we could solve that the insulation thickness is equal to 0.246 meters or 24.6 centimeters. So, ibig sabihin, pag 24 centimeters lang yung gagamitin ko sa insulation, may makakatakas na init. Pero minimum na 24.6, wala nang makakatakas na init from the furnace. Okay? So, pag 24.5, hindi pa rin siya pasok sa minimum. Ibig sabihin, meron pa rin makakatakas na init doon sa furnace ninyo. May mapupunta pa rin dito sa may 80 degrees na side or air side ng inyong ng inyong insulation material. Okay? That's for number 2. So, if you want to solve for their total heat transferred, then that will be 0.0, or we just compute for one side. So, 0.01 times 650 minus 30, so divided by 0.3. So, then our Q now per area per second is equal to 20.67 watts, or that's 57 watts. Okay? So, let's have example number 3. For number 3, the inside temperature of a furnace is given at 2250 kelvins. The furnace has a circular glass viewing of 6 cm diameter. So, if the transmissivity of glass is 0.08 and the Boltzmann constant is given at 5.67 times 10 raised to negative 8, determine the heat loss from the glass window due to radiation. So, for our solution,
we'll use now the equation of Q transferred for radiation. Q is equal to sigma times A times T raised to 4 times T, or this is tau. So, we're given your sigma. Where's our sigma? 0.8. Our Boltzmann constant tau is 5.67. It's given. We're given the temperature. Okay. So, we're given, not given the time. So, basically, this would also be the heat transfer per unit time. And we have your area from the diameter 6 centimeters. So, for that will now be equivalent to your Boltzmann constant, 5.67. The area is pi r squared times 0.08 times 2 to 50 K. So, this will be your Q per time. So, computing, Q now is, or the Q loss will be 3.28.7 watts. Okay? So, watt siya kasi it is, this is joules per second. Okay? So, example number 4. The bulk temperature in a steam room is 24 degrees Celsius. The entire room is heated by a 2 by 1 meter ceiling pipe, which is 3 meters long, at a rate of 5,000 watts. What is now the temperature of the pipe surface? So, this is now an example of convection. So, for our solution, we have to identify first what is our H. So, for the H, the steam pipe is installed in the ceiling, so therefore, it is a horizontal pipe. So, kung naka-install yan sa ceiling natin, so nandito, so ibig sabihin, the air now is at the, flowing at the bottom surface. So, in that case, we'll now use the equation for H, wherein we have a horizontal plate in which the heat passes at the bottom surface. So, we'll have H is equal to 1.31 times the delta T raised to 1/4. Okay? So, since delta, kailangan natin ng delta T at ang hinahanap ay yung temperature ng pipe. So, this will be T hot minus T cold. Okay? And we know that for convection, our equation is H times A times delta T times the time. So, in that case, we equate now H in this equation. So, with that, H now also, pag in-equate natin, pero pwede natin siyang isimplify with the power given. So, the rate is P equal to work divided by time, or the heat divided by time. So, therefore, T cancels out. So, the power now is equal to H times A times delta T. So, equate H here. So, for our surface area, we could compute it as 2 times 2 times 3 plus 1 times 3. So, ang surface area ninyo, so, ang given natin is 2, okay, so that is 2 by 1. Tama ba? 2 by 1. So, surface area, ito. So, 2 times 3 plus 1 times 3. So, the surface area is equal now to 18 square meters. 2 times 1, tapos. Okay, so ito 3 meters. So, ang hinahanap ko is itong area na to, tapos itong area na to. So, that is 2 times 3, tapos 1 times 3. Okay?
Tapos, dalawa yun. Kaya, total is 18 square meters. So, yung surface area ng buo. So, with that, we can now solve. P is 5,000 watts. We have 1.31 times TF minus 24 raised to 1/4 times 18 area times TF minus 24. So, TF lang ang unknown. So, you can solve this by simplifying. So, TF now is equal to 96.63 degrees Celsius. Okay, that's it for heat transfer. Thank you for listening. If you want more examples for your modules or for this module or this topic, heat transfer, you always can check your modules. It's already posted in our class.